Hey everyone, my name is Connor, and today I'll be talking about how Pluto notebooks are web APIs. This allows you to interact with Pluto notebooks from Julia scripts, Python scripts, web apps, or virtually anywhere else that can make HTTP requests. And the three main features of this API are that it can read variables, call functions, and thirdly, change variables temporarily and see the response that has on other variables. So let's take a look at these features in action. So the first thing I should stress is that everything I do in this Julia REPL can be done from virtually anywhere else, as I've mentioned before. So we could start out by just using HTTP and make an HTTP post request to these API endpoints. But to shorten our code a little bit and make it easier to interact with this API, I've created a client library called Pluto REST Client. And this exposes a structure called Pluto Notebook, which will allow us to interact with this API without having to manually type in the HTTP requests. So the first argument and only argument that we'll need to provide is the name of the notebook we want to interact with. So in this case, you can see in the upper left, it's Pluto Notebooks rapis.jl. So what that does is creates a reference that we can use in the future to make API calls. So now, let's say we wanted to perform the first function, which is reading variables. All you have to do is type in whatever your notebook variable is. So in this case, that's NB. And then dot, if we wanted to get A, we could type in dot A, dot whatever variable name that you want to get. So dot A will give us a 2. As you can see, A is equal to 2 on the left. We can do the same for B, and we can do the same for C as well. But something a little bit different happens when we try and get notebook.my function. We can see on the left that my function isn't a variable per se, but rather a function. And the different thing about functions is that they can't be serialized. So in other words, they can't be sent over HTTP. Because remember, that's how this code is actually interacting with this notebook. It's through this HTTP API. So what we have to do instead, you can see if we try it, we get something called a Pluto callable. Its implementation isn't necessarily important, but all it does is allows us to call this function as if we were running it locally, even though we're not. So if we type in a 3 and a 2, it'll add those together. So the important thing here is that when we do make this call, it's not actually calling a function in our Julia REPL, but rather calling a function in our Pluto notebook and then giving us back the response. The last function that this API can perform is changing variables temporarily and measuring the response that that has on other variables. So Pluto is reactive. If I were to change A to 3 over here, we can see that that change reflects in C. Now, we can do the same thing, but from our Julia REPL through our HTTP API, which is now built into Pluto. And we can call our notebook structure as a function and provide as keyword arguments the variables that we want to change. So let's say we want to see what C would be when A is 4. So we would set A as a keyword argument equal to 4 and then use that same dot notation that we used above to get variables, so dot C. And that will evaluate C as if A were equal to 4. Now you can do this with one variable, two variables, as many variables as you want. So I could also set B here to set it to 3, 2, 1 instead of 1, 2, 3. And it's reverse now. We could also just set B, and that would set A equal to its default, which is 2. So now I'd like to demonstrate this API in action in a practical scenario. So right now I have open a tic-tac-toe application that I've written that allows you to play against a computer. So if I click on any one of these tiles, my game piece, an X, will get placed down, and then shortly thereafter, the computer will make a move. So every time I click, the application is actually making an HTTP request to this Pluto API. And it's using this Pluto notebook over here as its backend. So it's using this Pluto notebook to figure out what the move the computer should make actually is. So most of this notebook is dedicated to computing the model that we use. And then once we actually do that, we have this small section down here dedicated to just making it a little bit easier to make API calls from this application. So all we're doing is taking in two variables, the current player that is going to be placing down their piece, and then the current state of the board, so essentially where different X's and O's are located at a given instant. And then the application just asks back for this next state, which is just the new positions of game pieces, including the computer's move. And so by doing so, we can actually leverage the API and use the Pluto notebook itself rather than having to write a custom implementation all in one. Before I go, I'd like to wrap up by restating a couple of the most important points. So first of all, what you see is what you rest is built directly into Pluto. So you don't have to install anything or change any configuration. All of these features should be enabled by default. Secondly, you can use this API from virtually anywhere because it's HTTP. There are a couple of client libraries that I've written to make it a little bit easier to use. You saw one of them that I wrote in Julia, but I also wrote one for Python and one for JavaScript as well. You can write your own, or you can interact using the raw HTTP API as well, if a client library does not exist for a language that you want to use. And lastly, I'd like to thank you for tuning into this presentation. You can contact me at connor@pluto.jl.org or on the Julia Pluto Zulip channel if you have any questions or comments about this feature. And yeah, thank you so much for watching.